Hey guys, so today I'm just going to be doing a vlog. I just want to try some new makeup with you guys and just have a bit of a glow up. I have got a new foundation that I really want to try. It's by Makeup Revolution, Conceal&Glow, this one, and it's in the shade F3. Now I know straight away this is going to be too light for me, so I'm going to have to mix it. But I'm going to mix these two. So this is the Dream Urban Cover full coverage, and then this one is a medium to full coverage, but I just don't think it might work because I need to self tan, so it might work, I don't know. Anyway, this is going to be a vlog, so it's going to be a chilled vlog because so many of you guys say that you prefer the chilled kind of vlog style. And so do I. I love it. It's so easy to meow. Snugs is in here. It's so easy to film when it comes to vlogging. I just want to share a lot of new makeup that I have got. I also want to share these products. Now, this is in collaboration with a brand called Jolie Beauty. I think that's how you say it. But they have kindly sent me across three products. So we have got two blushes and one bronzer. Now this is their new blushes and bronzers. So I'm so excited to try these. There is going to be a collaboration over on my blog, so I will link that down below and also put it on the screen so you guys can check that out, because that's going to be more full detail, pictures and everything, like a proper review. But I thought that I would share it on YouTube as well, because I know a lot of you guys love makeup. I have recently fell back in love with makeup. Like, I don't know why I even fell out of love with it. It wasn't really that, it was just like having a baby, it kind of just takes your mind off of makeup because you just don't have the time. Now we're in local lockdown where we live, so I've got a lot of time on my hands. And I have Liam around, so I'm able to get a lot of filming done, so I'm trying to make the most of it. Anyway, so I'm just gonna do a little bit of moisturiser. Now, I actually use Olay moisturiser as a primer. If you watch my videos in the past, you'll remember that I've always done that. I've just never really bothered to buy a primer, like a proper primer. I've always just used this Olay, and I absolutely love it. So, Snug, stop making so much noise. I'll show you guys. It's very thick. It's a very, very thick consistency. So it really does well for keeping your makeup in, like, on. This one is the Olay Normal to Dry Day Cream. This one is so good. And then I've also used the Beauty Fluid, which is really good as well. Anyway, so it's Monday morning, well, afternoon. And this weekend has been pretty stressful, with just basically Olivia, she's teething, she's waking up in the mornings at 4 o'clock and she wants a bottle, or she just needs cuddles and stuff. So I'm pretty tired, so I'm sorry if I sound different, but I am pretty tired. It's just one of them things. It's probably just like a growth spurt or something. Or sleep regression, I don't know, but she has been through this before and we got through it. So I don't know if you guys will know, I have recently changed my whole filming space. So now I have got my basically Olivia's drawers, but I've got a few like glossy box and PR behind me, and then I've got my mirror there. Because the other way was just like a door behind, and I don't know if it's just me, but whenever I watch someone's videos and they've got a door behind them, I always feel tempted to look at that door. I get really anxious. I don't like it. So I'm happy with this space. Snugs! Snugs, get down, please. She's literally walking behind my camera. Get down. So yeah, I hope you guys like it. I have got my Hollywood mirror, my DIY Hollywood mirror in front of me, and then I've got my ring light. But I don't know if this is even gonna be necessary. Let me just pop it on and see. And see what it's like. Okay, so that is with it. I don't know. Do you know what? I think that is so much better. So I am trying to get the lighting perfect. I know it's gonna be a struggle because I'm not professional, but I wanna get the lighting as good as I can. So I've got my ring light and I've got my Hollywood mirror lights, and then I've got my window here. The only thing I was worried about is the window, like, to being too bright, and then it's just too bright on my face. Anyway, rambling. So I am just gonna be filming a bit of a glow up. I just wanna do my makeup and feel nice and pretty. I just want to feel good, you know? So I'm just doing my brows. I am on a journey with my brows. I'm pretty much on a journey with myself. I really am at the moment. I have tried to be so I've tried to be comfortable in my own skin. And it sounds really silly, but I just wasn't comfortable in my own skin, and I am now. And I'm really enjoying having no makeup days and just having really good skincare products, because skincare is so important, and it just gives you another world of confidence. So I'm trying to get my brows to look the way I want them. And what I want is I don't want the fluffy look, because it just wouldn't suit me. It looks lovely on other people, but just not me. I like the way my brows are, but I just want them to be a bit bolder, and maybe I should get microblading. I don't know. I really don't know, but I'm quite a natural person when it comes to stuff like this. So, Snugs. Sorry, guys. So I literally just like try and fill them in and make them darker as such rather than bigger. This is like my natural brows. Anyway, okay, so I think what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna do some eye makeup first, and then I'll move on to foundation. This is what I've always done. So I don't really know what palette to use. I don't even feel like I have any palettes anymore. I don't know where they've all gone. Ever since I've moved house, I just feel like I've lost so much stuff. Anyone else? I think I'm just gonna use a Pixie palette. Yeah, I know what I'm gonna do. Oh, this chair is not comfy at all. I need to get a new chair. So I am gonna use this Pixie palette that come in a PR package. This one is called Reflex Light, and it's got like a load of shimmers in. It's absolutely stunning. And I don't want to do anything crazy, like I'm not here to do any autumn looks or anything at the moment. I literally just want to snug. Please stop meowing. I'm busy, I'm vlogging. I'm just trying to get on with everything that's going on, because it's just so crazy. This lip balm is so good. It's by Nivea. They sent this out a long time ago, Mango Shine. Really tastes so good. I'm just trying to get on with everything like as best as we can, because literally it's just local lockdown again, so we're kind of quarantining again. But you know, it has to be done, and it helps other people, so that's good. I have downloaded, I don't know, comment down below if you've downloaded the NHS taste. Melissa, comment down below if you have downloaded the NHS Test and Trace app. There's so much controversy about it. I'm just gonna do a bit of bronzer eyes, just because I don't really want to do anything too crazy. Yeah, I have downloaded it, and I'm literally just, you know, keeping an eye on it, making sure everything's all good. But I did upload a vlog the other day where Liam went and got tested for COVID, and it's all good, it's all fine, but this app lets you know if you have been in contact with anybody that has got it. So it is a good app. I know that everyone seems to be getting on with it and using it and stuff, so it seems good. Anyway, I've just done the tiniest bit of bronzer eyes ever, and then I'm gonna use maybe, do you know what, I think I'm gonna use this really, really white shade. But I'm just gonna make the most of it and just vlog as much as I can when I can, and just get on with my work and stuff like that. Snugs, you're crazy. Oh gosh, anyone else's cat absolutely not job. I'm waiting on a few parcels, so maybe they'll come today, who knows. Oh, I think there's a cat outside meowing, that's why she's going mental. Okay, that is the simplest look ever. Oh well. It is what it is. So, anyway, I have dyed my hair. Again. No, I've dyed my hair. I used to be dark brown. Ever since I started my channel, I had dark brown hair. And I was looking for my older videos and my pictures, and I was just like, who is this person with this light brown hair? It's just not me. This is me, dark brown hair. It's not even dark brown. It's, I think it's called chocolate, natural intense chocolate or something like that. And I'm loving it. I much prefer it. I feel like it just goes with my skin tone so much better. So, oh my god. Snugs! Anyway, I recently put a giveaway up and I've had a few of you guys enter, so that's great. If you want to enter, I'm giving away a L'Oreal Paradise Mascara. And I'm giving away this as well. I was going to show you, and I think I forgot to show you in the video. It's this. Stop it. This coffee scrub that I got in the glossy box, because I don't like coffee. So I thought I'll give it away to you guys. So if you want to be entered for that, please read the description down below and I will put that video up. And all it is I just want you to subscribe to my channel, and comment what kind of videos you like, if you like chilled vlogs like this, or if you like makeup videos. Snugs, what are you doing? I need to let her out. Makeup videos, or like anything, like what do you want to see on my channel, that kind of thing. So I hope you guys can enter, that would be great. I have gained quite a few new subscribers, so thank you and hi. Good luck to you. I hope you win, whoever it is. She's trying to get in the wardrobe. Snugs! Hang on guys, I'm gonna let her out. She's doing my Sweden. I seriously need to get myself a comfy chair. This is unreal. So uncomfortable. I've really been loving the mascara look. You know, just like a natural mascara look. I don't even wear falsies ever. I don't think I've ever really worn falsies. Well, I have, but not on a day-to-day. Like, I generally don't know how people do it. I'm just too lazy. So, back to the makeup that I was sent. This is actually a huge collaboration for me. This was what I was on about if you follow my Instagram. This is the huge brand collaboration because they are a really big brand and they reached out to me. Got really bad acid, sorry. They reached out to me and they asked me to work with them. And I was just like, wow, are you sure? No, I was just like, absolutely. So make sure to follow my blog so you don't miss out on stuff like that, because there's so much sponsored content over there and things that I get sent, or, you know, things that I write about and stuff. But anyway, I hope you guys are doing good. I have got quite a bit to film. I want to film some first impressions. Today I'm just going to have a very, very filming day. I'm just solely dedicating today to filming, and that's what I like to do. I like to have filming days and then I like to have editing days, because I don't know how people can film and then edit within like the same day. Saying that, I will be doing Vlogmas. That eyelash is so short. Why did I pull my lashes out? Such an idiot. I pulled them out when I had extensions. I've absolutely ruined them. Look, I'm trying to grow them. I'm on a journey. I'm on a journey with everything. I'm trying to grow them. But anyway, what was I saying? Makeup, I think. Look at these, honestly. Do you know what? I keep getting so red on my face. I don't know why. In fact, I think I'm gonna do some color correcting because, honey, I'm red. Like yesterday, I looked like a beetroot. I actually love this color corrector. It's by Collection Last Imperfection. It's just a green one. It's just green. That's it. I've just got so much redness everywhere. So annoying. It's mostly like this area. And like here. So this foundation that we're going to be trying, I got a while ago. Well, like, no, I ordered it a while ago and it's only just arrived. But I really am looking forward to trying it out, because I love trying foundations out. Now, the thing is with me though, I need a foundation that is gonna cover my redness. So I'm hoping it's good. It says it's medium to full, I think it's medium to full, or is it light to medium? Medium to full coverage with vitamin C. Sounds good. So like I said, I am actually gonna I'm gonna use it to get a first impression. But then if I need to mix it, I will. You know, whenever I do my makeup like glam, I always color correct because I've got so much redness, it's unreal. I don't know why, but I really do. It's strange because every night before bed, obviously I'll do my skincare and then my face is like so red. And then, when I wake up in the morning, it's okay. But then throughout the day, it gets red again. But I tend to really go with that foundation. Like I mostly wear tinted moisturizers because I just like to let my skin breathe. Because I work from home, I don't really wear much makeup. So I just try and go with tinted moisturizer or just nothing, you know, like a moisturizer, a plain one. So I don't know, but I want to try this foundation out to see how it lasts and how it blends, because also it's very important how good a foundation blends. I always get so red on my nose as well, basically everywhere. It's just basically everywhere. I much prefer this dark hair. It's so much better on me. So much better. Okay, so we are going to do some foundation. This is too light. Oh, honey, this is too light. I don't think it's going to be enough. Okay, so coverage is good. It's not full because it says it's not full, and you can see it's not because you can still see like marks and stuff through it. But it is what it says, which is good. It's a little bit light, but do you know what I'm gonna do? I'm not gonna mix it. I'm gonna give you a full first impression of it. So as it is, as this color. But then what I'll do is just bronze it up, hopefully with them new bronzers. So I'm gonna do half of my face and then I'll show you guys the difference. Okay, so bear in mind I've color corrected, so it's a bit difficult to see, but this is pale. This is too light for my skin. But look, the coverage is not full. Now for me, I want a full coverage because I just need it because of the redness, but if I was just to go on like a normal day, a summer's day or something like that, then I would appreciate this foundation. Now this is a conceal and glow, so it basically is like a concealer but it gives you a glow. So it does conceal your skin, like it does conceal, you can see that the coverage is pretty good, but it's so glowy. I honestly don't know if you can tell on the camera, but this foundation is super glowy and I'm here for it. I like it. I just wish I got a darker colour. That is so annoying. Oh gosh, okay. What we're gonna do is we are going to just do the rest of the makeup. Because like I said, I'm gonna have a glow up today. I just wanna look more done up. Okay, so I'm gonna do a baby contour. Wait, no, concealer. So I'm gonna use this Clinique All About Eyes Concealer. This is actually a new product for me as well. I picked it up a little while ago. And again, I don't know how it's gonna be. So we shall see. It's darker than the foundation. Oh, gold. Oh no. Okay, so it's a bit darker than the foundation, but we're gonna have to roll with it, guys. We're gonna have to roll with it. The normal, I don't know why I would think that that foundation color, it's so hard to tell online. Like, I'm so used to going into the shops and wow, this coverage is good, but it's too dark. I'm so used to going to the shops and looking at the foundation. Now to me, when I looked at this online, it looked like my perfect skin color. It does, do you know what I mean? But it's so light, it's so light. So we're gonna have to just work with it. But I know what to do, I've had this problem before, and what I do is I just bronze it up and then it looks a lot better. So please don't judge it off of this. Let's wait till the end result. I've been trying to play around with my camera this weekend to try and get the right settings in place, because I feel like sometimes I feel like the quality is just not good, and then I read about my camera and it has got good qualities and it has got the potential, so it's obviously just me. I need to learn how to use it properly. Anyway, I always go in with a stippling brush. I've always done it. I just feel like it blends everything in place. This one is by B Superdrug, and I get lots of questions about this. It's such a good stippling brush because it just blends everything, and do you know what I mean? Anyway, okay, so, wow. Do you know what I love about this foundation, first of all, is the fact that it is so lightweight. Like, it literally doesn't feel heavy on my skin. It feels like I'm wearing quite a, well, a heavy moisturizer. Now this is very heavy, so bearing in mind this is on my face as well, so it's hard to tell, but this is very lightweight. I like it. It doesn't feel cakey, it doesn't feel heavy. I've got hair on my nose. Okay, so I'm gonna do a baby contour, and wait, which one's, that's a blusher brush. Okay, so I'm gonna do a baby contour. I'm using, see my lighting goes funny, I'm using the Gerard Cosmetics Starlet palette. You get one bronze and then you get two blushes. This one is just too orangey blush, but I like these two. So I'm gonna use this one and do a baby contour. This palette smells like holiday, like it literally smells like a holiday. Okay, I'm just doing a very, very light baby contour, like I said. Okay, right, so what I really am looking forward to is trying these new products out that I've been sent by Jolie Beauty. I hope that's how you say it. So they have sent across a bronzer and then they've sent two blushes. So I'm gonna use the bronzer first. This one is in the shade Latte. They asked me what skin tone I am, and I'm hoping this is gonna be the right one. They picked it, but they asked me what my skin tone is. So, ooh, this could be nice. This is the shade and it's called Latte. The palette, the product is called Second Skin Powder Bronzer. So, but let's just try and see how this goes. Do you know what? It is very, very light, light feeling, and I love that. I really love that. Do you know what? I really love this. This is actually really good. I love it. It's not like made anything very sort of, bearing in mind I've done a baby contour, but it's not made anything muddy as such, because I hate it when it goes muddy. Just need to blend it out a bit. Guys, I love it. It's really good. I don't know if it's translating well on camera, but it actually looks better like in the mirror. It looks really good. So I love that. And I think that is my perfect color, Latte. Okay, so they sent me two blushes out. They sent me Rendezvous and Flushed. So I'm gonna look at them both and see which one would suit me better. Okay, so this one is Rendezvous. Wow, that is stunning. I love that. And then this one is Flushed. I've literally just pulled my nail apart. I need to get my nails done. This one here. Okay, so if I look at them both, this one is more of a corally colour, and then this one is more of a pink. Now, because I'm wearing pink, I think I'm gonna go with Rendezvous. So let's see how she works. Oh, I love it. Oh my gosh. I love it. It's so nice. I love it. I love the colour. I definitely think I went with the right colour. I think if it was more corally, it just wouldn't have gone as well with this sort of jumper. I love these products. They are so... Good job that notified me, because it said it stopped recording and I would have been yapping and it wouldn't have recorded. It is so powdery, but it is such good colour. I love it. This is good. I love this. This blusher, Second Skin Powder Blusher. So I'm guessing this is their Second Skin range. Okay, I'm gonna link these products down below for you guys if you wanna grab them. They are so good. I'm in love with them. I think I have a new favorite bronzer and blusher. Oh yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna move on to highlight. Now, I have really been loving, well, to be honest, I've been always trying this liquid chrome highlighting drops, but I don't want anything intense. I just want like a nice natural glow. So I'm gonna use this, and I've really been loving this like natural look. This is the Wet n Wild Mega Glow highlighter. It's in the shade Precious Petals, and it's broke. It's so good. I use it every single time I do my makeup. Look how stunning that is. Let me just like show you guys a swatch here. Absolutely gorgeous. Look at that. That is absolutely beautiful. Okay, so I'm just gonna pop Do you see what I mean? Like, it is quite intense. It's a very intense highlighter, but the highlighting drops are a lot more intense. Guys, this makeup, do you know what? I'm actually blown away by how flawless this makeup looks. And I know that sounds like, I don't know, that like I've always, it sounds silly, but I've always found the foundations look very dry on my face. So when I heard that they brought this out, Conceal&Glow, I was like, an illuminating foundation. I was really intrigued to try it because I like a glowy look. I've always loved a glowy look because I have really, really dry skin. And I am obsessed with this. Everything blends in really, really nice. So this really goes nice with the bronze and the blush and the highlight. Like, look at that. Okay. I love it. I really love it. Okay, so I'm gonna just do a little Rudolph nose. And a little, I wanna do a little bit of a highlight on my, just like below my brow. I love that look. Oh, too much. Way too much. I forgot I used that brush for my concealer. No wonder it went like that. Just use my finger. I'm gonna add a little bit in the corners if I can. I actually need to get some new makeup brushes. You guys recommend some good makeup brushes to try, because mine are just like not good, not great. Anyway, so I am going to move on to lips now. I feel like for me, the most important makeup product for me is brows. If I don't have brows, I look crazy. And lip, either a lip gloss or a lipstick, and mascara. They're the really important ones. I can go completely barefaced with just a bit of moisturizer, but as long as I've got my lips and my brows, I'm happy. I feel like lipstick and lip glosses just make such a big difference. And also, I'm so happy about these products because it means I have got a new mirror. I can use this mirror now. It's got a little doodah on it, but let me just take this thing off. Oh, how do you, I hate these things sometimes. It's so annoying. Oh, now I can see my makeup. Guys, it looks flawless. It looks so good. I love that foundation. I'm pretty impressed. I just wish I got the darker color. Yeah, so I don't know. This might be too, this color isn't gonna work. It's too, like, it's nude, but it's a brownie nude. Like, it's called Very Nude. That's too dark for me right now. I think I'm gonna use this one, which is the same brand, W7 Lip Twister, but it's in Champagne. This one is more of a darker color. And then I'm gonna see what we come up with. Yeah?
Is this juice
bowl freshly made today? Yeah. Okay, I really love that. I love that colour. Champagne. I'll try and link these products down below. And I don't know if I want to use MAC, Lady Be Good, or Kylie Coco K. Bearing in mind my jumper is like a blush pink. I think I'm gonna use the MAC one because it's a little bit more mauvey. Okay, it's kind of gone a coral colour. So maybe I should have used cocoa cake. Oh well. I'm just going to matte it down a bit because it's quite sticky. What I will say though is this lipstick will stay on for a long time. It's so good. Okay, so we are pretty much done with our little glow up session. So I'm going to use this Pixie Glow Mist. Look how much I've got left. Gutted. This also like adds glow. Look at that. Wow, I love this stuff. Look how much I've got left. I'm gonna have to get some more of this. They sent me it a few months ago and it's so good. I love it. Okay, so this is, let me just put that down because it's gone quite wet. Okay, so I'm glowy. I'm a glow queen right now. Okay, so this is the final look. I am super impressed with the foundation, as you guys have probably told by now. I love it. I love how buildable it is. Like, I know if I kept building, I would get a fuller coverage. But to be honest, I love that natural skin look, so I'm pretty impressed. Like, I'm not gonna lie, I'm pretty impressed. I will put the price of the product on the screen and I will link it down below for you guys. I just wish I got a darker colour and then I think it would have been perfect. I am definitely going to be using this a lot more. I love this, it's very, very good. So yeah, next product is the concealer. So like I said, this one was new to me as well. Clinique All About Eyes Concealer. I need to look at my colours a bit better because this was just a bit too dark for my skin. Yeah, so that's that. I think I should have gone for a darker colour, but I do love the coverage. It's definitely got rid of my under eyes, my dark bits under my eyes. I didn't even set any of this, like I didn't use any translucent powder, and it looks really, really flawless, so I'm happy with that. And I really honestly have nothing bad to say about these products. Honestly, this blusher, Rendezvous, and the bronzer is so good. Like, I will take a very, very good picture on my Instagram right now. So make sure you go and follow. It's Melissa Jane. I'll put it on the screen. Go and follow my Instagram so you can see how good, like, up close these products are. And I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. I'm gonna start another one now, so I wanted to make this a little bit shorter because if someone wants to come on and just see how the products are for the makeup, then they haven't got to watch the rest of my vlogs, if you know what I mean. So I just thought I would include this bit. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. Please make sure to subscribe and enter that giveaway. I'm gonna be holding it for 2 weeks. So I love you guys so much and I will see you in another video. Bye.